Hey, that's my name. Oh, you were introducing me.
So, Mr. Murphy, Neil tells me you're funny.
Sure, I'm funny. I mean, you mean ha-ha funny, not like funny, right?
I'd like to see how you handle some scripted material, Mr. Murphy. Mr. Piscopo will play opposite you.
That's good. Hey, good.
SNL alum.
Hey, Barry. Oh, hey, Eddie, how's it going?
Good, man, you have a minute? I have some ideas I want to talk to you and David about. I have some amazing characters I've been playing.
Well, you know, we are kind of set for the next couple of episodes, but, you know, maybe we can talk later on this season, all right?
Eddie grows increasingly frustrated until an hour.
I've got some time I need you to fill. Just do 4 minutes of your stand-up.
Sure, I'm doing some stand-up.
But keep it clean.
You haven't seen my stand-up, have you?
And he goes out, does his stand-up, and a star is born.
I'm like filling time. Dick sent out the most handsome man to fill the time.
You must have seen them taking out these advertisements in newspapers and magazines.
Oh, yeah, we've seen them. What was it they said? Oh, that the AIDS jokes are too harsh and excessive.
Right. Nothing short of inflammatory.
Look, I'm not the first comedian to make homosexual jokes. I'm not afraid of homosexuals. I don't have anything against homosexuals. I poke fun at everybody. It's just comedy. It's not real.
So, this doesn't bother you?
No. Let them make as many ads as they want. Let them waste their money. Y'all want dessert?
I think he wants to be out in Hollywood where he belongs.
How do you feel?
He's so ready to get the hell out of here.
Hey, look, y'all know I didn't want to come back this season, but Dick said that y'all job was on the line, so you know, I gotta come back this season. You will.
And while all appears fun on screen, off screen is another matter. Tensions run high between Eddie Murphy and the film's director, John Landis.
All right, I'm ready to roll on this. Let's go, everyone!
Do you need more time, Mr. Murphy?
Murphy will later allege that Landis is resentful of his success and seeks to undermine him at every opportunity.
I said, everyone, I'm ready to roll. You take your instruction from me. Don't be afraid of him.
I seen you. What happened to guys that are not afraid of me?
Ask that chick, they get messed up. Come on.
Despite the alleged confrontations on set,
I'm starting to feel like everyone's out to get me. Like none of this is even worth it anymore.
You can't let it get to you, man. Legally, at least this case is between him and Paramount.
You know, I came up with this idea on my bus when I was on tour. I never heard of this dude. What is damn treatment?
The case will haunt Eddie for 4 years.
Hey, Eddie, is there any truth in Michael Michelle's claims that you came onto her?
Come on, man, that's absurd. It's totally false. As you can see, I'm being attacked once again.
Eddie vigorously denied it. Nevertheless, that was kind of a shadow over the whole film.
So, Miss Michelle just made the whole thing up.
Look, she's someone else trying to get their shot.
It's 1991. When his girlfriend and daughter are visiting.
How's she doing?
Temperature's going down.
Let's get married. Serious.
Mary in 1993 made of the show that he gave so much to.
Look, children, it's a falling star. Make a wish.
Yes, that's right. You believe this guy? I saved this show. He wouldn't even have a job if it wasn't for me.
I remember that was
under prostitute wanted by police for violating probation.
It's 1 a.m. Where are you off to?
You dropped this young lady off at home.
And where would that be, young lady?
I live off Willoughby.
Now, would that be the same Willoughby that's 2 miles back in the opposite direction?
Guess we got busy talking.
I'm gonna have to ask the both of you to step out of the vehicle.
Murphy isn't arrested or charged with a crime, but the prying eyes call the comedy performance of his career.
Give me 1 minute.
Around the same time, his stepfather, Vernon, is diagnosed with lung cancer. So while his cartoon alter ego might be all smiles, Eddie Murphy, the man, is dealing with real life heartbreak.
All right, love you too.
Just weeks after the movie hits theaters, Murphy rushes to be by his stepfather's side as he succumbs to his illness.
Dad can be half the father to my kids as you've been to me. I love you, Dad. He's devastated. He's devastated.
His marriage and Nicole is falling apart.
The problem, you're always working. I'm basically raising this family by myself.
So what do you want me to do?
You know what? Go ahead, answer it.
I can't do this today.
In 2006, Eddie and Nicole divorce.
Dreamgirls. Congratulations on the movie.
Thank you.
Another new direction for you.
Yeah, something different, you know.
I really loved it.
Yeah, me too.
And I believe more congratulations are in order.
Excuse me?
I hear you're expecting a new baby with your partner, Mel B.
Now you're just being presumptuous. We're not even together.
Mel B has announced
that. Hey. Why are you reading that mess?
Because I'm almost like I can't win. I bust my butt doing a good picture in a supporting role, and then all of a sudden I'm the bad guy. I'm a sole loser.
The loser? Huh? Maybe you just won a Golden Globe. Just stop reading that. It's not worth it.
The press.